Okay, now that we've finished talking about production, we can talk about cost in the short run. These are probably the most complex diagrams in the entire workbook, but if you are patient and go through them slowly, you can get an understanding of them. So we were going to look at this upper diagram first, and then we'll go to the lower diagram, and after we understand the costs, we'll put the revenues back in and talk about choosing output. Right now you can select output here and it moves it, but which output is the right output to choose, that will save for a little bit later. So let's explain this picture. There are three different cost functions in here. This horizontal one is the fixed cost, and the fixed cost does not vary with output, so it literally is just a horizontal line. The next one is this curve, which the blue curve, which is the variable cost curve. You get the variable cost curve by looking at the production function and inverting it. That is, for each output, you look at how much labor do you need at the output level to produce that output, and then knowing the labor, you multiply that by the wage, and that determines the variable cost. So this variable cost curve looks like the inverse of the production function, and in fact, it bends up at a decreasing rate. Let's raise output a little so it rises at a decreasing rate. That's because of division of labor, and then eventually it starts to rise at an increasing rate. When it rises at an increasing rate, that's because of diminishing returns. The red curve is the vertical sum of the variable cost and the fixed cost, so that's the total cost curve, and it is parallel to the variable cost curve. So that explains that diagram. Okay, and now we're going to look at the average cost. We're going to be taking those cost curves from above and dividing them by output, and we have three curves above, so we have three average curves. This red one is average fixed cost, and since fixed cost doesn't change, it's fixed cost divided by output, which looks like a rectangular hyperbola. This next one is average variable cost. Remember, the average productivity was humped this way, average variable cost is humped the other way, and this curve is average total cost, which is the vertical sum of the green curve and the red curve. The green curve and the blue curve get very close together at high output levels and are far apart at low output levels, where average total cost is determined primarily by average fixed cost. This last curve is marginal cost, and recall, marginal cost is below average cost where average cost is falling. It's above average cost where average cost is rising, and it cuts average cost at the minimum. In this case, marginal cost cuts both minimum average variable cost and minimum average total cost, so minimum average total cost occurs at a greater output than minimum average variable cost. Okay, now we're going to turn on price information. So we're going to make the picture even a little bit more complicated. Here is a price line in this picture. Let's go into the above picture first, and here's the revenue line. And let's note the following. It's always possible to produce zero. If you look at this picture, revenues are always below variable costs except at zero. So in fact, this is a picture where producing zero is the best thing to do. I just hit a button I shouldn't have. Let's raise the price a little bit, and let's keep raising it until the revenue line cuts the variable cost. Okay, now there's a region where revenues exceed variable cost, and you'll notice as we lower the graph, now price is above minimum average variable cost. So when price is below minimum average variable cost, produce zero. Otherwise, the place to produce is where price equals marginal cost, and we're actually pretty close to it. That's that output. Price equal marginal cost is where producer surplus is bigger, as long as you're covering variable cost.